Welcome back. This is another video for the quest intro to machine learning image processing. Let's scroll down and open this one, this lab, APIs Explorer, quick start. Click on it. Before pressing the start button over here, be sure that you have 30 minutes free time because there is no pause button. You have to either start it or stop it. Okay, over here you can see that we need to get 100 score. If we click on it, we see that we have only 3 areas to check our progress. So I'm pressing the start lab. I'm not a robot. I will use my subscription, of course, and please be sure always to work on incognito or private mode, whatever it is on your browser, in order to avoid, instead of working on Qwik Labs, to work on your real Google Cloud projects. So over here, copy the username that is created for us and open Google Cloud Console, paste it. As you can see, we are with a student account. And now we need a password. Don't write your password, go back, copy the password that it was given for us, paste it, accept everything. This is a very good solution when you are working for your project to have a two-way authentication. Confirm, continue. We have another pop-up over here. Yes, we agree, and we are using a student account, so it doesn't matter if you click check it here or not. Agree and continue. And this is the platform, Google Cloud platform over here. If you over it, you can see that we are using the student account. That's why we don't have anything. And this is our Qwik Labs project, which is over this one here. Okay, so what we will see is how to work with Google's API, and we are scrolling down. We need to open the cloud cell. If we click over here, it opens down, and this Debian Linux 5 GB disk with a lot of stuff pre-installed for us to make our life easy. Okay, and it's a good advice always to use these two commands, gcloud authenticate list, so it shows the account that you're using right now, because you might have different accounts for different projects, and this command is to check that you are on the correct project over here, and we are. So let's continue. First, we need to create a storage bucket and give it a name and then create it. So let's go back over here, and as you can see, they are separated in parts, identity, security, compute, storage. We need to go to the storage. We can close this, create a bucket. We need a unique name. It is like the domain names, it must be unique. So a good solution when I am doing these labs is to copy the project ID, because it is unique, it is created for us, and we are the only ones that can have it. And now create. So we are here, this is our bucket, the name. We can check our progress. We got the check, and over here we have 25 points, so we can continue. Now I'm going to download and rename it, because I didn't rename it, so I have to go it as demo image. Okay. And now we need to upload it to our bucket. So let's return back, upload files. This is the file. Over here, you see that it is already completed. It's a demo image JPEG, but it is not available for everyone. So we must give permissions. But first, let's check our progress. It's green tick, 50 points. And now we can go to edit permissions. Over here, the three dots. Great. And we need to add item and put all users. So add entry. Public for entity. Public all users for name, this one, and reader for the access, it's here. And save, we can save it. Let's go back to the lab, check our progress. It's a green tick. Let's come over here. We don't get anything. We've earned 50 points. The lab has finished for us. But if you want, you can scroll down here, go to, in order to make a request for the Cloud Vision API, to the APIs and services, this one, and then search for the Cloud Vision and select the Cloud Vision API. I want to copy it, and over here, Cloud Vision API. It is enabled, so we can continue. If this is enabled, click this link. Great. And now go to requests over here. Click over this blue button. Select requests, blue button, add item, again, blue button. Let me see what we need to have to put here. Features. This one. Features. Over here. Add item. Over here. Type. Type. And over here. Label. Label detection, this one, and now we can go down and select, okay, below, over here, with image, and source and image URI, source, image URI, and we need to write this one, but please pay attention. Let's go back and copy the GCP project ID. As I told you, it is the name of my bucket. So I need to clear everything here and put the name of my bucket. Now it is ready. We need to be sure that both of them are checked. Great. And then we can execute. So whatever we did over here is translated, is shown over here directly. Now we can click execute the student account, allow, and we get back a response saying that we have grass with a score of 0.97. That means 97.82%, and topicality means how important it is for the image, the grass, the green, 97%, we have green, skin, and all the other stuff over here. So let's go back. To test your understanding, you will do it by yourselves. And don't worry, if you don't find it, you have still finished with this lab. You got the points that you needed. And if you make some mistake on this, then it will be easier for you to remember it because it was a mistake. Great. Thank you for watching this video. See you on the next one. Bye.